Hi everyone, just out for a short hike today. We are in Tai Tam Country Park, around the middle of it, just off of Tai Tam Reservoir Road. And what we've done is we've come up one of the drainage maintenance staircases over there. Way off that way is an anti-aircraft battery, or at least it was, and the main emplacements and supplies for the crew would have been there. But there would have been an artillery battery, possibly up there where the electricity pylon is now, right? No sense wasting flat land. This is Hong Kong after all. So as we go up there, we notice a few structures off in the trees. And in case you see it, there is one right there. So why don't we go and take a look? Now, the last time I was here, I think I slipped on that stone, actually. Fell and got a nice scar coming up here the last time. Now, someone's been here and cleared away most of the brush. Okay. And here we have a nice toilet block. Oh, it's a blocked off drainage there. So let's go and have a look in here. And here we have the enlisted toilets. So please have yourself a nice squat. Now, I'm sure if something had been dropped down here, that goes quite deep, but we can kind of see the bottom. And I can't see any drain or anything down there. I mean, there very well might be. I'm not going to ask. And this one, there we are. Let's go have a look down this one. Certainly would not like to lose anything down there. Okay. Now, if we proceed a bit further, around the corner here, we have the officer's toilet. Now you can see where the toilet seat was bolted in there. Oh, and how nice, a little ventilation shaft. Isn't that great? So let's go have a look in here. See? Let's see. Oh, some toilet paper, someone's used it. There's a few geckos and gecko eggs enjoying themselves down there. Isn't that wonderful? Apparently they don't like me doing that. All right, so once again, would not like to lose anything down there. Okay, let's head on out. And there we are, and we are right below one of the residential towers, Park View. So let's proceed back along the path, back along the stairs, because where you have a toilet, you have a bunker, or as we should be calling them, a splinter-proof shelter. Now, this is the splinter-proof shelter I was taken to years and years ago, and the actual stairs to it are over here. Here we are. Here's a little, nice little bit of concrete right there. So we're supposed to go up there. Oh, there's some more concrete. Yay. Right. So we're supposed to go up this way. And as always, the metal of the shutters was quite valuable in the post-war period as scraps. So probably used as a squatter settlement for a little while before having everything ripped out. Normally, if the government knew about it, they would just brick it all up. Okay. So it's our standard splinter-proof shelter. If a bomb goes off nearby, you'll be fine if you're in here. If it lands right on top, there'll be pieces of you all over the place. And the hooks for where the beds, the folding beds, are still intact. And up here we have the hooks to hang your helmet. And over here we have the hook to hold the kerosene lantern.
But
the interesting part is down this way. Now, the last time I was here a few years ago, this was completely overgrown. But someone's been here and has cut through a path. So let's follow it. And what do we find? Another shelter. But look, the door is quite thin compared to the other one. So why don't we go and have a look at this?
Right.
Here. Oh my. Well, it's in much better condition. Let's see. All right, so we've got the usual graffiti, danger. Oh, more of the hooks are intact here, though. A few of the metal bits are collected over here. Well, someone had written something, but that's long faded. I won't be of any help here, I'm afraid. We can kind of still see up the ventilation shaft, so that's good, it's still clear. Yes, well, yeah, quite the nice little fixer-upper. Not quite sure why the door is so thin, though. Ooh! Well, there's a part of the door right there. Now, as we proceed up the path, we find a third splinter-proof shelter. And here's some other adventurers I've been digging and placing whatever they find on the windowsill. And here's the amazing part. Look, if we go this way, we find yet another, a fourth splinter-proof shelter. And these are in fantastic condition, comparatively. Looks like this one has been slowly filling in. But again, the metal hooks are still here. It's in really great condition, too. Oh, now this is very interesting, everyone. So I've come out one of the paths. Sorry, I can see the electricity pylon now. And just off to my right, we have a bit of concrete. Now, this is usually unusual to find in the middle of the wilderness. So, go and have a look. Oh my, what on earth could this be? Is it some kind of underground shelter? Oh, let's go have a look. Oh, very interesting. Let's put our tools down and shine our light inside. What do we have here? All right, seems to be room-shaped. Magazine for the artillery shells, perhaps? Quite possible. It's all filled in, mostly. Let's see if we can get in a bit closer here. Interesting. It looks to be about the correct time period. Very interesting. Not sure what this could be. Well, and what do we have over here? Just spied another little bit of concrete through the undergrowth, and there's another one over here, and looks like there's a tunnel inside. Let's go have a look, shall we? All right, so I've managed to clear away some of the brush from the entrance over here. Let's go turn on our lights. There we are. And let's go take a look. What is in here? Not very much at all. Kind of greenish on the inside. Copper residue, maybe?
So with a handy flat surface, I thought it would be great to send the drone up and have a look from the sky as to what I was standing on. You can see a bit of a circular path here, and inside of that is a depression where the other structure perhaps ammunition magazine is. But when I got up further, I was really amazed because I was standing right next to what had to be another splinterproof shelter in the top right, and some other kind of structure or tunnel or room in the top left. So I had a good idea of where I should be heading.
Well, here is the building that we were able to see from the overhead drone view, but looks like no one's been around here in a very long time, quite overgrown. We'll see if we can get over to the rooftop, which was quite clear, and find out what it is. Oh my, now this is quite interesting. So it looks like this is the back of a splinterproof shelter. The door over there has collapsed. If you look over here, you can see the crenellations over there. That's the front. So this is the front. Why on earth is there a window at the back? Is it because it's just on this isolated hillside? Let's go and have a look. All right, so we're inside. We have probably for a fire, I suppose, remains of a chair, large bit of concrete that has fallen in from somewhere. Oh, this Pepsi bottle is quite old, though. I haven't seen that style in a long time. And just the usual junk that people find in here. They just leave things lying around. Interesting, it circles the wall over there. What would that have been for? The door's been busted in, fallen apart. And it's pretty much all overgrown over here. So if there are steps leading up or around, this was the front. So going out into there, there would have been a path. Which means, you know, well, I'm not going to be the one to dig it out. Not today, anyway. All right, well, previously unknown shelter. Not bad. Lucky find. All right, we went crashing through the brush that way and got to the pylon. Didn't find the little tunnel entrance thing, so came back a bit and noticed that there's a bit of a depression in the earth here. Right, something's been dug out in, like, a circular formation, which is similar to the other one, so I can see a path just through there. And right there, I can see some concrete. Now, it's going to be interesting to try and find out how to get over there. Looks like I need to go this way, curve left. And there's something over there. All right, so let's go try and take a look.
This way.
Step that way, curve this way. And there we are. Okay. Oh, I'm standing right on top of one. All right, so what in the world is this? Is this for a building the electricity pylons? Looks like there's steps. There were steps. Water supply, maybe? Well, let's stick our head in and have a look. Okay. All right, now there's very obviously steps going down. Kind of hard to see, but... Oh, look at that, we got a whole underground chamber down there. Let's see now. But again, it doesn't look very big. Oh, spider web. Okay, but, I mean, it's not that big. I guess it's a good place to hide, I suppose. Ammunition storage, maybe? Huh. Well, we have a wonderful path through the bamboo through there, but it's starting to get late, starting to get dark, and I think it's probably best to head back to the main road. So, until next time, please keep your eyes open. You never know what you might find.
And of course, a special thanks to my supporters, Gerberhead, Telkontar, and Fredfall.